I'm here in Central Park in New York, and it's just a beautiful day, and there's so many little worlds within worlds here you can get yourself into. And I was walking, and there was an area where a bunch of kids were playing. And this little kid, like maybe 3 years old or so, or four, he was chasing a bubble, you know? Someone was blowing bubbles, and there was a bubble, and he was chasing it. His face was so lit up, he was so happy, and he was kind of like just learning to run, and he was chasing it and giggling and smiling, and he was so focused on catching that bubble, and this little bubble was floating, and he was coming to it, and just as he put his hand out, the bubble disappeared. Thin air, vanished, as if it was never there. And then I don't know why, but I had a thought, like, kind of, it's like a metaphor for all of us chasing our dreams or chasing the pursuit of happiness, you know? And, you know, and then right as we, just about as we're about to get it, it can disappear. Or maybe we will get it, but it will disappear. And the thing I thought was fascinating was the little kid, the bubble disappeared, and there wasn't even a second of disappointment or crying or lamenting. He literally just ran off and chased something else with the same joy. And I think that's that place that maybe we once all were and that we can all discover again. So if you're maybe you were in a pursuit of a great relationship, or you had a great love and you worked it, but it fell apart. And usually after that, people are just wrecked, you know, for years, maybe for life. Maybe it's career or fame or money, and it eluded you. And it really goes back to this sort of Zen mindset of the journey is the way, the journey, the joy of it. And then just get on to the next joy. The sooner you can get on to the next joy, the longer you'll live, the more fuller life you'll live, the better you'll live, the more you'll be present in your life. So enjoy the journey, enjoy the chase.